Yerpy.
Hey, what's up, guys, from YouTube? JRob447 here. And today, we got some NCAA football 12. And this is my Houston Cougars dynasty. But first and foremost, I would like to say happy Thanksgiving. And this is on Saturday, but you know what? Who gives? Anyway, I didn't do anything on Black Friday because I had to come from Charlotte. Yeah, that's why I didn't put out a video, because I was in Charlotte. And I didn't bring my computer because I was at my auntie's house. So, yeah. Anyway, we're in this game and we're versing UCLA. And I changed up the schedule a little bit because we're in the Big 12. Now I changed it. And if you hear that Lil Wayne song, you know what? I was feeling really stupid. So I had to put that in there because Lil Wayne actually went to Houston, if you didn't know. But Houston, they won against Tulsa. So they'll be going to the conference championship game for the CUSA, and I'm really amped up for that because they're gonna be if they get undefeated this season, I'm gonna be so happy. And looks like they might be able to go to a BCS bowl, because look at it. Okay, look, the Rose Bowl is going to suck. You know why? Because Stanford is the only eligible team in the top 10 to go to the Rose Bowl if they went out. But there's no Big 12 team. There's no Big 10 team. So, who's going to step up? Exactly, nobody. So, it's either Boise State. And the only reason Boise State is still there is because Georgia didn't lose. Georgia did lose, but Georgia is like number 15. So, that loss is like, so that win still keeps them in there. But that don't make no sense, because last year, they were like number 16 after they lost to Nevada, who was number 24, and they beat Virginia Tech, and Virginia Tech was having a good season after they beat them. Like, that's some bull. But anyway, we got Case Keenum. Yeah, I got the updated rosters. Yeah. But Case Keenum, he's a great QB, especially with that long ball. He could catch you with that long ball. I don't know. That long ball is crazy. And Bryce Beal, he should be injured. Well, not exactly, because he just got back. I'm not from Houston. I'm from New York, okay? So Houston is not the thing on my mind. Even people from Texas probably don't think Houston on the top of their mind all the time. You know why? Because they got like freaking 10 other colleges to worry about. But anyway, yeah, UCLA is going to be winning by like 10 points. Then I catch up to them, and then they done. A perfect pass to Patrick Edwards right there. Picture perfect, and that is what Case Keenum could bring to the table. So can his wide receivers. I mean, Tyron Carrier, really speedy. I didn't get to him that much in this game. Justin Johnson, like, man, I don't know. I should put, like, Tyron Carrier. Nah. You're going to see later in the season how I'm going to use Tyron Carrier in the Wildcat or whatever, because he's really fast, and I'm going to have to use him. But Justin Johnson, he's a great slot receiver. I'm not going to lie, and I had to change up my play because they were going blitz, and they overloaded that one side, and I was going to get nowhere. So, I just had to do this, scrambling. Oh, I almost caught him. And people, if you're wondering, I am playing on varsity, but you're like, oh my God, you suck. Dude, do you want to see an entertaining series, or do you want to see a boring series with me losing every game? Because if I'm mad he just dropped that. Did you see that? He just dropped it. Butterfingers all day. Butterfingers, yo. Man, he don't even want a He don't want a Snickers. He want a Butterfingers. And, is this the play where I'm doing the sweep? Nah. But when I do the sweeps with Tyron Carey, it's almost a touchdown every play. I swear. Almost a touchdown every play. And Bryce Beal with a nice run right there. That's why I like him. Because he's speedy. He could break a couple tackles here and there. But in like real life, Hayes, he's doing it, and so is Sims. But there, you could be like, oh, they all they got is a passing game. Not exactly, because their running game is pretty good. Because they got like two running backs with over 500 yards, which is really good. They're sharing the rushes, and of course their running game is not going to be the best. They got the best freaking quarterback in the whole NCAA. And another point I wanted to get to is, why wouldn't they want to rank Houston higher with Oklahoma State's loss? I mean, you wouldn't want to see the best offense, passing offense, the best points for versus the best defense in the whole freaking NCAA. You wouldn't want to see that. Dude, it's going to be crazy. And you say, oh, Arkansas, they got the best offense. But guess what? They only scored 17 points, and they got blown out because freaking LSU scored 41 points. Are you serious? Like, you, no, no, no. See, today it was funny because I was Charlotte. Right before I got on the plane, I was at my aunt's house, and me and my cousin Michael, he 23, but he's from Texas, and we was watching the game a little bit, and it was 13-10. Houston winning. I was like, oh boy, hopefully they win. You know what they did? They stomped on them, son. 48-16. And that's what they did with SMU. They was like, all right, SMU, we'll give you a little daylight. Bam. Gone. Beat them by 30 points. That's what they do. You remember when they was versing, I think it was Rice. Oh, nah, it wasn't. Yeah, it was Rice. Rice was beating them by like 17 points. Nope. Scored 73 points on them. Just like that. Just like that. What other team can do that? What other team can do that? So anyway, we got these slants. And yo, I'm feeling good about these post routes right now. Oh my God. Oh, bad decision on my part. Anyway, we're still losing. That is not good. I was getting nervous while playing this game. I did not want to lose my first game of the season. But no, this is how Houston plays. When they losing, they will be like, nah, F that, we gonna win. F that, we gonna win. And this is what we're showing you right now. We are going up the field. UCLA, man, that's gonna be my future alma mater. I'm sorry, I wanna go to UCLA when I grow up, because there's no way I'm staying in New York. Maybe I'll go to UNC, but I'm not staying in New York. And I was gonna go to Ohio State, but yeah, Ohio, not so much. So I'm going to go to L.A. because, you know, they got a good town right there. L.A.? Boy. And they give athletes $2,000 spending money. But I don't. Did he just drop that? Did he just drop that? Oh, my God. Can I slap you in the face? Can I slap your mom for birthing somebody with butterfingers like that? Like, God, it's like she got wet on your hand. Oof. Oh my God, and he drops that. This is not Houston football. This is pussy football. I don't know what y'all doing. What are y'all doing? Another thing that they should add to the Dynasty mode is upgrading your stadium. Like, I would like to upgrade my stadium because these stadiums aren't exactly state of the art, if you know what I mean. But you know, this game has a lot of stuff in it. You know, you really can't do that. You really can't, because it's too much in the game. They have so much that they took out and so much that they put in. So you're like, oh, they took away. And they took away. Oh, they retarded. But look what they put in, dude. The graphics are freaking awesome. 3D grass. Oh, yeah. Are you serious? Did he? No, no, no. How are we going to win this game? How are we going to win this game? Bleach, I don't care if you're online. You could day. Okay. Okay. Great. Freaking great. We're losing by 10 points at the half. Oh, my Lord. We ain't going to win. We ain't going to win. Forget it, y'all. We ain't going to win. Got to find out something pretty nice. And I'm trying to do a screen. But you know what? You know what? I don't think it's going to work. Even though that side got nobody, it's freaking go, run. Yes, that's what's up. That's what's up. You get that first down, and we in business. So, lining up to the ball. Oh, yeah, the person who made this roster for the team, the fullback is fake. Because they had the number for him. And, like, oh, another thing about college football numbers. Why do they have to wear the same numbers? I know there's, like, freaking 80 people on the football team. But, dang, there's 99 numbers. No. Wait, can you have zero? Can you have double zero? If you can, then that's 101 numbers. If you can't, then that's just 99 numbers. But, like, Jesus Lord, like, I see on teams, like, they have at least three numbers that are in use twice. But they just can't be on the field at the same time. Like, Fozzie Whitaker, he wasn't in the game on Texas. So there was this one kid, he was the cornerback, and he was wearing his number. But he didn't have a last name on his jersey. So that's kind of bull. Because, like, I want to wear that number. Y'all can both wear the number. But who's ever better is going to get their last name. So I'm sorry about that. Man, that's some bull. I would have been like, okay, 77, I don't really care if I'm a quarterback. Let me just get that number and I'll be straight. Because you see freaking, you see wide receivers with quarterback numbers. Oh, I'm wearing number 14. I'm wearing number 10. You seen DeSean Jackson's number 10. You seen Jeremy Maclin's number. Oh, my God. Are y'all retarded or something? You know freaking they wear something. In linebackers, you know, I'm not going front. 40 is a fullback number or linebacker number. 50s is linebackers numbers all the way. 30s, 20s is running back, cornerbacks. Safety, same thing. What else? You know, I swear, Tyrann Mathieu, why'd you have to change the number? Now you looking retarded. You looking really retarded. But basketball is something different because, you know, you could just wear, you can't wear. If your number is over 50, people look at you like you're retarded. If your number is over 60, people look at you like you're retarded. Like Nicholas Batum, you're wearing number 88. What is wrong with you? Are you smoking crack? This guy is smoking crack. And can we get the touchdown with Hayes? No, Hayes can't get the touchdown. Hayes, he's really doing good this season for Houston. I've been watching him. He's doing really good. I don't think he's an NFL prospect, but, well, I don't know. Isn't he like a junior? I don't think he's a senior yet. He's a junior. Oh, okay. He's a junior. But, yeah, we're going to do this QB sneak. And Case Keenum, he scores and he puts up the little claw sign for, you know, Houston. No? Okay. But, yeah, we score again. Did we score? No, it was a long run. This is going to be the next score that we did. Now we're in business. Now we're winning. And we are not going to let up. We ain't going to let up. And it's a holding penalty. Of course. Blaming on the kids from Houston. But one thing about being Houston is, you got so much competition. You got Texas Tech. You got Baylor. You got Texas. You got Texas A&M. They're stealing all your prospects. But the only good thing is that Texas has like a freaking 23 million people. And almost a lot of people in Texas play football. Texas is like the best football state. And so is Florida. And probably California. And you say, and yeah, Ohio too, but yeah, Texas, are you serious? Forget it, but Texas, yeah, they got a lot. They got Sam Houston State, they got Texas State, they got UTEP, they got North Texas, they got Rice. I mean, they have a lot of colleges there. They have a lot. I'm sorry, they got too much. They got too much. Way too much. And we're giving the ball to Bryce Beal. Beal, he gonna score. He gonna score. But hold on, folks. That's what they be saying. Hold on, folks. Terrell Douglas, the fullback, the fake fullback, the FF, was freaking holding. Are you retarded? Look at, yo, that mascot is ugly. I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, Lee Corso. He wore that mascot hat when he cursed. If you didn't hear that story, yeah, he cursed. He was like, and he had the SMU horn. He was like, ah. And then, oh, Bryce Beal, he scores again. Yo, Bryce Bill. Bryce Bill. Well, he's a boost. Bryce Bill is a boost. You can't touch him. Can't touch him. Can't touch him. Can't touch him. And, yeah. Do we get the ball back? Yeah, we scored. I didn't show you that because it would be too much. Anyway, we win. J-Rob 447. The best comment. Whoa, I'm not the best. But anyway, Icy's commentator on YouTube from Long Island, J-Rob 447. Peace. And happy Thanksgiving, y'all.